Picture Arts and Sciences. Ben Casey will be seen next week at its regularly scheduled time over most of these ABC television stations.
From Santa Monica, California, the annual Academy Awards. Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences invite you to be its guest at the 37th Annual Awards Presentation.
Yeah, the Pacific Palisades had an awful time finding it. Took me 5 minutes.
The best to you, Lee.
Mr. Dick Van Dyke and Mrs. Van Dyke. One of the exciting highlights of Oscar night has always been the arrival of prominent motion picture personalities from Hollywood and in this
Mr. Jonathan Winters is now arriving. Let's have a big welcome for Mr. and Mrs. Jack Jonathan Winters, ladies and gentlemen.
Mr. Dick Van Dyke.
Jack, once again,
and Dick Chamberlain,
my fair lady.
Accompanied by Miss Joan Marshall.
Thank you, Jack Warner.
And this is durable, magnificent Agnes Moorehead, a nominee this year as Best Supporting Actress for her role in Hush, Hush, Sweet Charlie. Miss Greer Garson, perpetually lovely Miss Garson, appearing tonight as an awards presenter. And Margaret, together with Roger Smith. Anne's career received a tremendous boost by her appearance, singing one of the nominated songs a couple of seasons ago.
Good evening. So good to see you.
This elegant Deborah Carr, frequent Academy nominee. Mr. Anthony Quinn, a Best Actor nominee for his performance in Zorba the Greek. Also a past Academy winner. This is George Hamilton.
We ask you to come up, please.
A lovely Lila Kedrova, a nominee for Zorba the Greek also.
Good evening.
And welcome to sunny Southern
nominated
California.
Nominated for a supporting actress, being interviewed here by Mr. Army Archard. This is Jane Fonda.
And that was on what occasion?
Accompanying Jane, Roger Vadim.
We're going to be seeing you soon in Kathmandu, right? And we look forward to it. Thanks very much. Miss Jane Fonda and Mr. Roger Vadim, ladies and gentlemen. Now,
another representative from the medical field.
Peyton Place, Rat Patrol, and Iron Horse, which will immediately follow this special program.
One of the highlights of Academy Award night each year for motion picture fans across the country, and especially for those here at Santa Monica Civic Auditorium, is the arrival of the glamorous celebrities. The star of great stature, Mr. Jimmy Stewart, accompanied by his twin daughters. One of Hollywood's most durable leading men, Mr. Glenn Ford. And here's Patricia Neal, former Oscar winner for her performance in HUD. Handsome Rock Hudson. And ever glamorous Ginger Rogers. Robert Mitchum. And with a Mary Poppins umbrella, Dick Van Dyke. This year's nominee, Anouk Aimée. For a man and a woman. Here's beautiful Raquel Welch. The 40th annual.
And in the heat of the night, One of the highlights of Academy Awards night is the arrival of glittering stars. You've seen Sonny and Cher, this is Carol Channing, and Carl Malden, beauteous Natalie Wood. Greer Garson, an all-time favorite. Shirley Jones with husband Jack Cassidy. Rosalind Russell. Audrey Hepburn. Magnificent Raquel Welch. Paul Newman with Barbara Rush. And Sidney Poitier.
Years, Oscar night has defined excellence and elegance to a watching world. Each year, the most glittering stars on earth come together to shine and be a part of Hollywood's biggest and most glamorous event. Welcome to the Oscars Red Carpet Live.
A storm has
Red Carpet Live.
What a thrill to be here on the most famous red carpet in the world for Hollywood's biggest night. For the next 90 minutes, we're bringing you all the glamour, excitement, and high fashion of the world's brightest stars glittering.
The 70th Anniversary Academy Awards. The stars are out tonight in all their glory to celebrate Oscar's 70th anniversary here at the Shrine Auditorium in Los Angeles. And the movie fans have been gathering since early this morning to catch a glimpse of them. And here are the stars they have come to see. Two Hollywood legends, Louise Reiner and Roddy McDowall. Who else but Cher? First-time Oscar nominee Greg Kinnear. Joan Cusack, supporting actress nominee. Best actor recipient for Gandhi, Ben Kingsley. The beautiful newlywed Sharon Stone. Marlee Matlin, Oscar winner for Best Actress. Samuel L. Jackson presenting tonight. Gloria Stewart, nominated supporting actress for Titanic and oldest nominee ever. Amistad's Jaime Unsu with Hollywood's top reporter, Army Archer. Faye Dunaway, Oscar winner for Network. Minnie Driver, nominee for Good Will Hunting. Oscar winner nominated for The Apostle, Robert Duvall. Elegant actress Sigourney Weaver. Two Oscar winners, Holly Hunter and Frances McDormand. Kate Winslet, nominated for Titanic, her second nomination. Past Oscar winner Jeremy Irons. Helena Bonham Carter, lovely Best Actress nominee. Drew Barrymore. Jack Lemmon. Joyful Oscar acceptor Cuba Gooding Jr. Angelica Houston, Oscar recipient for Fritzy's Honor. The original 007.
Actress winner Jodie Foster. Here's Best Actor nominee for My Left Foot, Daniel Day-Lewis.
Jodie Foster, yeah.
Also nominated for Best Actor, Morgan Freeman. Presenting one of the major awards this evening, Mr. Dudley Moore. The man who lived and created Born on the 4th of July, Ron Kovic. The beautiful Isabella Gianni, nominated for Best Actress. The very funny Chevy Chase. Best Supporting Actor, Martin Landau. Best Actress nominee, Jessica Tandy, and her husband, Hume Cronin. Oscar winner, Jessica Lange, nominated again this year. Tom Hanks, nominated last year for Best Actor. Los Angeles, California, the motion picture capital of the world. It's the 61st Annual Academy Awards. One man, no baby, Tom Selleck. Fatal Attractions, Ann Archer. And moonlighting tonight, Bruce Willis and Demi Moore. Another nominee tonight, Max von Sydow. Here's High.
She wanted, so that car that gave her problems. I'm just curious, but I'm honest. Though you're wondering why I've been calling, like I got ulterior motives. Though we didn't end this so good, but you know we had something so good. I'm wondering, can we still be friends? Can we still be friends? Doesn't have to end. And if it ends, can we be friends?
Find out what groups had their groove.
All right, guys, I am here with No Doubt. Three nominations. Congratulations on yet another spectacular Grammy showing. You guys, when you made this record, you said you were in a good place when you made it. It was a happy album. Has this been a happy experience promoting the record? Because it's been a while since the record was actually recorded.
And we had such an incredible tour. I mean, we just came home to L.A. and we played four arenas sold.
Academy Awards are the most anticipated award show of the year, but as much as the night celebrates the work of great artists, it is also a night of Hollywood glamour and a celebration of fashion. Oscar's wearing Escada. She channeled old Hollywood in this red silk gown with a one-shoulder design paired with beautiful jewels and Jimmy Choo shoes. Coming in at number 14 is Anne Hathaway in Armani Privé. At the 2009 Oscars, Anne was nominated for Best Actress for her role in Rachel Getting Married. She wore this strapless gown with a diagonal pattern that was created using Swarovski crystals and was glowing that night. Number 13 is also glittery, but in a very different way. In this figure-fitting, edgy gown, Naomi Watts wore Armani Privé to the 2013 Oscars. The silvery sequin floor-length gown had a shoulder cutout, and she was shimmering, accompanied on the carpet by husband Liev Schreiber. She was nominated for Best Actress for her role in The Impossible that year. Coming in at number 12 is Charlize Theron in Gucci. Charlize was nominated for and accepted the award for Best Actress for her role in Monster. If you've seen the movie, you would never have believed the transformation. Having just returned from Brazil, the South African native showed off her bronzed skin in a glittering gold gown that people couldn't stop talking about. Number 11 is Camila Alves in Kaufman Franco at the 2011 Oscars. This black dress was simple but elegant, with a plunging neckline and princess-type bottom, and looked perfect next to Matthew McConaughey on the carpet.
Brilliant colors shining bright at the 88th Annual Academy Awards Sunday night, where gorgeous gowns were center stage on the red carpet. Best Actress winner Brie Larson looking regal in royal blue Gucci. Charlize Theron rocking a plunging red Christian Dior number, while Brooklyn's Saoirse Ronan glimmered in green, giving a nod to her home country of Ireland.
Calvin Klein made it for me, and it was something that, you know, I didn't want to think about what I was wearing to the Oscars before I got nominated, because I'd be very superstitious.
Spotlight's Rachel McAdams also going green, wearing a gown by August Getty that she says her sister picked for her.
She's very stylish, and she doesn't mince words.
Best Supporting Actress winner Alicia Vikander stunning in custom Louis Vuitton.
You feel beautiful. You whispered in my ear, it's Chanel.
Yeah, it's Chanel.
White also wowed, Lady Gaga mixing it up, wearing a jumpsuit with a full train. Olivia Wilde looking ethereal in white Valentino, while Quantico's Priyanka Chopra looked angelic.
All right, movie lovers, we are right here at the 89th Academy Awards, and I'm here with my good friend and colleague, Ms. Tanya Hart. And I mean, it's an exciting season. It's one of the best film seasons in a long time for me.
For everybody. I'm extremely excited. I would really like to see an upset tonight. I would like for Hidden Figures to be the upset. I really would. I don't know if that's going to happen, but that's what I would like.
I think it's a good chance. I'm pulling for Hidden Figures also. And
yeah.
I kind of feel like it's going to be the big upset. So we'll see about that.
I know. Wouldn't that be wonderful?
That would be wonderful.
But in the meantime, there's just a lot of other good stuff.
There's a lot of great stuff to celebrate. It could be a lot of firsts this year.
Yep.
It could be a first Oscar award for Miss Ava DuVernay, who's been really tracking hard. And it's also a first for Netflix if that happens.
That's true. And honestly, I think she's going to win in that category. I mean, there are so many great documentaries. It's a tough one, but I think she's going to win only because she hit the pulse just at the right time with the right information that we just all didn't seem to know.
Right.
So there you have it.
Yeah. It could also be a first for another streaming service, Amazon.
That's
which
right.
Purchased Manchester by the Sea. So it's a chance of a big disruption this year with the Netflix and Amazon's getting into the mix and finally bringing home some awards.
That's true.
Very likely. So what about the main actor nominees? I mean, last year was Oscar So White, and this year we have 7 nominees.
That's what I said. It's like unbelievable. That's history making.
Yeah.
I'm actually as excited as I am about that. People say, really? I'm excited that Joy McMillan is nominated for an Oscar, first time ever, for a woman, an African-American woman, for editing.
Yeah.
That's huge.
Yeah, that's big.
That's very huge.
That's big.
You know? So I'm hoping that she'll win. I mean, and that's for Moonlight.
Yeah.
So who knows? But, and you know, the other part of it, La La Land, 14 nominations. Okay, let me just tell you, I love that movie. I love the opening scene. That is one of the most diverse opening scenes of any movie that we've seen ever.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Either way you look at it, it's just a good year.
Yeah. La La Land's not one of my favorites, but I'm a little partial to the musicals. But,
yeah.
I mean, I did think Emma Stone did a great job, but I really think Natalie Portman did a far, far greater accomplishment with
Jackie.
With the role of
Jackie.
Yeah,
well, she did. And unfortunately, she won't be here tonight. She's way too pregnant.
Yeah. Well.
Yeah, they said. And I was wondering, because we just saw her, I don't know, one of those award shows. I thought she was too pregnant to be there. And I was like, ooh, I'll be surprised if she makes it to the Oscars. So, you know, anyway.
Well, maybe she'll take home a golden baby tonight.
I know. She won't be here to accept it. So maybe that means we can go get it for her. And that'll get us into the Vanity Fair party.
That's what we need to do.
That's what we need to do. Let's run up and pull a Kanye West.
So that's it for now. We're going to be on the carpet talking to all these great stars. Y'all just keep it locked. Stay tuned. We'll be bringing it to you.
We'll bring it to you. Okay.
For real, Mimi. Let's talk some Hidden Figures, man.